Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Today I wanted to talk to you about getting an accurate quarter inch seam allowance. Now, you can buy lots of different notions on the market to help you get an accurate quarter inch seam, and you can do some homemade things as well, such as measuring over from your needle a quarter an inch and maybe putting a pad of sticky notes there, post-it notes there, and then that'll keep your fabric guided to go up through the needle. But with my Janome 9400, I actually have some really helpful feet that will give me that quarter inch seam allowance. So I wanted to show you these. This is one of three needle plates that comes with the Janome 9400. Now this particular one has three holes in it. It's actually a single stitch plate, and you have the option of having your needle in the center, which is typically where we have it, or you can move it to the right or to the left. Now when you're using this plate, I like to use the O foot. Now this is the quarter inch seam allowance foot, or quarter inch foot, that comes with the Janome 9400. And as you can see, part of it is black, so the foot itself is silver, but there's this black piece too. Now this is actually an extra guide, and that comes out, it's not flush with the bottom of the foot, but it sticks out a bit. It's going to go along your fabric, you're going to run your fabric along it, I should say, and that's going to make sure that your fabric stays where it should so that the needle can stitch exactly a quarter inch away from the edge of the fabric. So that's very helpful, and I was used to having this on my Janome 8900 as well. So that's what I typically have been using. Now with the 9400, you also get this second needle plate, and there's one more too, a zigzag one of course, but you get this one, which is new for them. This is the HP needle plate, and it comes with the HP foot. So if you're wondering what the foot, where you can find out if that's the right foot or not, it's on the back here, it says HP. Now this foot, as you'll notice, is actually on its own holder, okay? Unlike the O foot, which is one of the ones you can take on and off your regular foot bar, I call it a foot bar, needle bar, this one has its own attachment. So you just need to take this and screw it onto the machine. So you don't, you get to use it with anything else. It's all by itself. It's special. Okay, and you're going to use it with the HP needle plate. So this one here, when you take a look at it, it's also a single stitch needle plate, but it only has one hole in it, and that's on the far left side. So when you put this foot in, either foot when you put it in, the machine's going to sense what's in there, and it's only going to allow you to do stitches that are going to work in the holes in the needle plate. So when you put the HP needle plate in, the machine will only recognize, I think it's four stitches, straight stitches, that you can do with this plate in. So it won't allow you to do zigzag, obviously, and it's not going to allow you to move your needle over either. So it stops you from doing that, which prevents you from breaking a needle when you hit the plate or messing up the timing on your machine when you hit the plate. So I have been using this plate and the HP foot because the HP foot is like a quarter inch foot. When I'm sewing with it, the distance from the needle over to the edge of the foot is a quarter of an inch. And so it works really, really well. It makes a gorgeous straight stitch. And of course, that's what we're using when we're piecing, right? And it's got that quarter inch distance away from the needle. So it's perfect. So I've been using this an awful lot on my new Janome 9400. And by the way, just to go back one second to this previous needle plate, when I'm working with this one and I want that quarter inch seam allowance, that quarter inch stitch, I'm using the number 2 in the quilting area. It's the Q2 stitch that I'm using. That's your quarter inch stitch. So either one will work and give you a very nice quarter inch seam allowance. I'm just finding I'm preferring this one a little bit. Sometimes I don't like having the guide on there. Sometimes I'm moving the fabric away a little bit. So if I have two pieces of fabric and one of them isn't cut quite right, and it's maybe not matching the edge of the other one so much, I might want to move them over a little bit. Maybe my bottom piece is a little bigger and the top piece is a little shallower, a little not quite as wide, and I want to make sure that I'm doing the quarter inch from the top piece, not the bottom. If I'm using this one with the guide, you know, the bottom fabric's hitting against the guide. It's not working so well. So I don't have that issue with the HP foot. So I kind of like that better. So if you're like me and you're not a perfect piecer or perfect cutter all the time, you might find this HP foot and the HP needle plate works really well if you have a Janome 9400. If you like this video, and I hope you do, I would love it if you give it a thumbs up, a like below. And also, if you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do so, and you'll get fresh new content from Chatterbox Quilts every single week.